So let's take a look at the Arrange tool. It's been around for years, but I think a lot of Mac users still don't understand exactly what it does and how it's different than sorting. So to best look at it, let's switch from icon view here in the Finder to list view. So we see a list of all of the files and folders and things in this folder called Docs. Now, if we want to sort these, then one way to do it is to click on the column heading. So here I've got name and date modified and size. So if I wanted to sort them, say, by size, I can click on it and it will sort them by size, and you can see the little arrow here that indicates the direction of the sort. I can click it again and it sorts in the opposite direction. Same with date modified. And to get it back to alphabetical order, I can sort by name and go in either direction. A lot of people, though, see the Arrange By menu either through the button here or going to View Arrange By and instantly think of Arrange as sort. And all they want to do is sort by something like file name, and they go to Arrange By and then they get results they don't expect. Arrange By does something different. What it does when you select one of these is it will group files together. So let's do Arrange By Kind. Notice now that everything is broken up into four groups in this case. There's a bunch of folders, there's documents, there's PDF documents, and images. And inside each one, things are sorted alphabetically. Now you can still sort inside each group by clicking on a column head. So if I wanted to sort by date modified, it doesn't change which group things are in, but inside each group it's sorted by date modified. You do the same thing with size, even with kind, because even though we have Arrange By Kind turned on, inside these groups like documents there are some subgroups like plain text files, RTF documents. So sorting by kind will change the order inside those. So what happens is people go and say, I want to sort everything by name, and they select name to do a sort by name. You don't need that. That's Arrange By Name, not sort by name. What you want to do is set Arrange By to none. In other words, turn the Arrange By function off and then just simply click on the column headings to sort by file name. So why have Arrange By Name there at all? After all, if I select it, I don't see any difference. It's not like it groups it together by the first letter of the file name or anything like that. So what does Arrange By Name do? Well, Arrange By does something else in icon view. So let's switch back to Arrange By None and go to icon view. And now we've got icons here. Now I can move these wherever I want, and I can create any kind of arrangement, group them together, just put them different places randomly. But when I turn on Arrange By, it's going to ignore my placements and group them together. So let's try Arrange By Kind here with icon view. You can see it groups them together in those same categories: folders, documents, PDF documents, and images. And you still see them as icon view, but now you can't drag them around anymore. They kind of snap into place. So when you choose Arrange By Name, what it does is it arranges the icons by name, and you no longer have the ability to drag them around. But if you switch to None, it remembers the positions where you put each icon. So that's why there's Arrange By Name. When you're using icon view, you can have it automatically snap into place. If I were to create a new file that was between the letters A and H, it would fit right in here and everything would move over. And None gives me the ability to place it where I want. Now in list view and column view, it really doesn't make a difference whether you use name or use none. So if you want to sort files the way you want to sort them, then certainly set it to none and don't mess with Arrange By. I personally don't use Arrange By very often. I usually have files of one type or another inside of a folder in my organization structure. So having Arrange By None is fine for what I do. But for some things it could be really useful. Like for instance, date added, you know, groups them together by time. You can do different things, you know, grouping by tag, grouping by application that's used. But let's say that you do want to clean this up. You could use Arrange By Name and it will lock into place, but it's still remembering that you've moved things around there. So what you want to do is with Arrange By None selected, then you can go to View and Clean Up or Clean Up By. So if you say Clean Up By Name, it's going to actually physically move each one there. So now these are still things I can move around and drag, but using none, they're all in kind of in their proper place. So a lot of times when people use arrange by to get things nice and neat, what they really want to do is use clean up or clean up by, and then continue to use arrange by none. Now arrange by also works in open and save dialog. So here I am in text edit and I'm going to do open, and inside of this open dialog you can see I've got the arrange by button here. So I can actually arrange these by kind, I can arrange these by size, and if I want it to be in alphabetical order I would go none, and then I would click on the column heading here. So another problem I see people having is they say arrange by name here, but they've got some other column heading selected for sorting and they don't notice that. So the best thing to do is just arrange by none there for alphabetical order, or use one of these tools. And you can also switch to icon view here as well. And here you can arrange by name and kind and all of that. And you can do column view there as well. So you can do that all in open and save dialogs. It works kind of like a mini finder window.